Hello, everyone. It's Roseanne. I'm here to share with you my design team, my second design team project for Angel Dream Crafts Kim on Etsy. And I showed you last time this pretty sign I made from her Etsy store. And this is her logo. And if you click on the links below, Kim sells merchandise, tote bags and t-shirts for women and tank tops and such. And this is the beautiful design that she has that she will put on those t-shirts and those tote bags. So it's the rose, and then it says Angel Dream Crafts, not designed for. But anyway, I just wanted to mention that. So if you want that really pretty rose on a tank top, you need to go over to Kim's link below. Okay, are you ready? I've had this done like a long time ago, but I've been so busy working on all my other stuff that I just was not able to do a video yet. But anyway, here we go. I made a really, really pretty wall hanging. Put it there so you can take a look at it. And this was made from, again, I have a packaging base. And then I have some of my own fabric that I found in a yard sale. And then this is the beautiful lace from Kim. It is a... It was a gorgeous, like, table mat. I love the roses. So I just cut it, just cut a section out, as you can see there, and added it to the back. And then I have all my Kim goodies here. I love saving these clear... boxes, you know, like when you buy croissants or whatever, you get these clear boxes, and I love to see, you know, my goodies, so I just stack them up, and then I can see what's in each container. I'll probably decorate it a little bit, but I do like to stack them up. Okay, and then this little bit here is from Kim's lace, so actually everything, and this one is from Kim's lace here. So I will show you where I grabbed that from. This one was, I don't think I showed you my pattern that I made for my other design team project. It's the Chaise Lounge, and if you haven't seen that, you can go over and see my video for the Chaise Lounge. Okay, so this flower is from this beautiful lace. And I just cut two. I cut a section because I used some down at the bottom. Well, you can't see. Some down at the bottom here, which I will show you. But I used the, you know, a couple of edges there of the flower. And then this gorgeous... lace, you can see there. I love the green. And then on the front, I just chopped this one, chopped it up. You see the little flowers there. And then this is some of Kim's beautiful vintage lace, which I put there. Gorgeous. Gorgeous, gorgeous. And then underneath, I put some coffee-dyed cheesecloth, and then this is one of my own curtains here, and let's see, the bottom layer is some of my fabric as well, and then I added this gorgeous lace, and I cut it. Let me grab it here. I cut it like this. And I used this part and this part. And this part is the part that I put here. And the other part I used on something else. But that's where you have that. And then I have the beautiful snowflake bling and the gorgeous little lace bow and flower that I just hand-dyed with some of my sprays. And then that bow is mine. And that lace is this one. I just cut the bow out, so this can go a long ways, because you can have the bow, you can have the scallop, and then you can have the top lace there. And that's probably what I'll do, is I'll be chopping that up. And then the blue, I use quite a bit of this one, because I used it for the chaise lounge also. But this is the rococo, beautiful rococo trim, and I keep keeping that down there so you can't see it. I'm sorry, guys. And then this is the beautiful peacock lace here. And I did cut one out for the chaise lounge, and I cut one out for this. And I still have plenty there. But I just laid her down and just cut around. And then before I do the top, underneath, I used that gorgeous lace. Of course, my fabric. And then that gorgeous lace there. And then I love this one. It's so pretty. I used that one there. And then the peacock. And then I took a piece of this one and hung it there. And then I took more lace from her other one, this one. I got a ton of that one still left, but I took just one and layered it on top. And then the butterfly, I cut, well, I actually turned it into a firefly, not a butterfly, but it's from this lace here. And I just cut in between and left two antennae, and then cut both sides and left one. So it makes it look like a little butterfly or firefly there. And then I used one of my blings. There is a bling from BB Craft here. And then these are just my stamens. And these are just all little bits. This is from this lace. Oh, this one is just too pretty. Too pretty. It's this one. You can cut all the leaves. You can cut the little flowers. I mean, these could be little hearts. It's just gorgeous. So I put that back there. And just more little bits. This is from the butterfly here. This was Kim's flower there. Beautiful. And just layers. Layers of bits of lace. You can see that particular piece there. Just the scraps from cutting everything out. And that's my own little flower there. And that's my own little flower there. And more stamen there. So little details. This one is my own little cheesecloth-y fabric type of thing. And you know I've got to have the fuzzies. So I added the fuzzies on the side. And this one is Kim's beautiful. It's a pearl charm with stars that I just nestled in there. I love to just like make layers and add dimension. As you can see, I really don't like things that are flat. So we have the little tiny bow there. And let me see if I can show you this up close and personal. And that's the beautiful flower. Is that not gorgeous? I love the height. It's gorgeous. And then these are the beautiful charm pearls. And I guess I should take them out so there's no glare. It's a hot one here today. There you go. So you could see. And this is, if you didn't want the star on there, this is all detachable. You can disassemble it. You could always use this for something else, right? And then you could just add this back. Where is the little... Round and round we go. Okay, there we go. So then you could just add this back, or you can add your own bead cap, or you can put a piece of lace on there. I mean, it's endless what you can do with this little charm, right? You can put it on the top, make it a knob for a little drawer. I mean, it's endless what you can do with this particular charm. So there's that. And I'm going to grab some coffee, guys, if you don't mind. Okay. And then this is the beautiful snowflake. I've already used a couple. Beautiful snowflake charm. And that's what it looks like on the back. Very high quality. Super sparkly. I mean, wow. It's crazy sparkly. And then she also sent me bows and, which I am gonna use for sure. Actually, I did use the bow at the top. I'm not done showing you everything yet, but look at how sparkly they are. So pretty. And I might hang a little heart there. I don't know. I think it's got enough goodies on it, but you know me, I like to add more. Okay, so that's that. I use the gold one. I love gold. That's my bling. That's my bling. And then that's the little bow that I showed you. And it is... Oh, I forgot to tell you about that. That bow is... It's like an insertion bow. So you can add... Like I did. I used that lace. You can send your lace right through it, or your ribbon. See that? See how it looks on the back? You can send your ribbon right through it. And let me grab... I want to get my shoulder. Let me grab my tweezers so I can just show you what I did. You just send it right through. Look at that. Isn't that pretty? So that's what I did up there. It's just absolutely gorgeous. I just love it. So that's what I did up there. And then I added, of course, my blings. And what haven't I talked about? I think I've talked about everything. Yep, I've got my fuzzies there. And I'll shore that up. Lay it down. This is a gift for someone. So I will make sure that's down. But yeah. The picture's not too padded. It's got some felt behind it, but the felt is kind of thin. And yeah, okay. So I think I've talked about all. I hope you guys like my wall hanging. And this is going to be boxed up and sent off. I had lots of fun playing with all these beautiful laces. Kim, thank you so much for asking me to represent your beautiful Etsy store with all these gorgeous laces. And if you don't go to her store when you see the laces, they go so fast. You're going to miss out. So once you see one of the designers displaying some of these laces, you need to run over there and get them, because otherwise they're gone. I wish stuff in my store would go that fast. But anyway, okay, here we go. What else can I say about this? I think I've said everything. Don't forget to go over and visit all the other designers. I will have them all listed below. And I think I heard a rumor about YouTube taking the description away. I don't know. I have to do some research, but if someone can confirm that for me, that's going to be troublesome for us creators that are representing, you know, other companies and things, because then we're not going to be able to put all the links and stuff. Where are we going to put all that? So I don't know. I guess we're going to have to start focusing on using the community page or something. I mean, I use that mine a lot, but I don't know. Anyway, somebody let me know. Please leave a comment. Please do the thumbs up or do thumbs down. Either one helps. And share the video if you like. That helps the algorithm for my videos. Click on the links below, guys. Go get some of this gorgeousness. And thank you again, Kim, for allowing me to represent your company and including me in your beautiful, talented group of ladies, design team ladies. Okay, bye everyone. God bless. And I will see you all later. Bye. God bless.